Hello everyone, in this video we have one triangle, and here is 40, here is 30, and here is given 50, and then this angle is given 20 degrees, and alpha is asked. Okay. First of all, notice that this triangle is an isosceles triangle, right? Because base angles equals 70 degrees. Okay, and then I want to create an isosceles triangle like this. So let's call here point K. Therefore, here must be equal 40 degrees. That means here must be equal to others. And then we know that this angle equal 40 degrees. So angle CAK must be equal 60 degrees, right? Notice that these two sides are equal. That means if we connect C and K point like this, this triangle is an equilateral triangle, right? So triangle ACK is an equilateral triangle. Therefore, here must be equal 60 degrees, and this angle must be equal 20 degrees. And then if you focus on this CK triangle, this triangle is an isosceles triangle, right? Therefore, DK must be equal CK. So the length of the DK must be equal to others. And then if you focus on AKD triangle, this triangle is also isosceles triangle. So these two angles must be equal 70 degrees, and here must be equal 10 degrees. And then we know that angle BAC equal 40 degrees. That means alpha is going to be 30 degrees. Okay, this was the first method. Now we will calculate value of alpha using second method. We know that here apex equal 40 degrees. That means angle DAC equal 40 minus alpha, right? In this kind of question, we can apply trigonometric form of Ceva's theorem. Let's remind you, if you have a triangle, let's draw here, and then let's take a point inside of this triangle, and then let's call these angles A, B, C, D, and E, F. According to the trigonometric form of Ceva's theorem, sine A times sine D times sine E must be equal sine B times sine C times sine F. Okay. Or you can start with angle C, it doesn't matter. Result will not change. Sine C times sine F times sine B must be equal sine A times sine D times sine E. It doesn't matter. Notice that A times D times E, these are same. And these are also same, right? Okay. But we use first equation. Okay. If we use this property for the question, therefore sine alpha times sine 30 times sine 20 must be equal sine 40 minus alpha times sine 40 times sine 50, right? And then sine alpha over sine 40 minus alpha must be equal sine 40 times sine 50 over sine 30 times sine 2n, right? So can be written as cosine 40 instead of sine 50, right? Can be written as 2 instead of 1 over sine 30. And we know that 2 times sine 40 times cosine 40 equal sine 80. So we know that sine 80 equal cosine 10, right? Okay. And then we know that sine 20 equal 2 times sine 10 times cosine 10. Therefore, these are again. So can be written as sine 30 instead of 1 over 2. Now we can see easily alpha must be equal 30 degrees. Thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe my channel. Bye.